Hi, good morning, my friends. This is Michael. I thought I'd record a video for you with the weekend fast approaching. And once again, let's just stop for a moment, give thanks for another day. You know, I always like to start my videos like this. Gratitude is everything in this life right now, and it anchors us in a very powerful possibility to love, create, and make a difference somewhere. Today's video is a tribute to Peter Kane and Darwin Ortiz. Peter Kane, back in the 1970s, published a series of books called A Card Session with Peter Kane. These books were really great. And as I became friendly with Darwin, he made me realize how much he appreciated those books. During the 1980s, I came across a routine called Jazz Aces. This routine was first published in Peter Kane's Card Session books. Very simple principle at work that we're all familiar with. But what was nice was he took the classic ace assembly and streamlined it down to just 8 cards, which made it very easy for the audience to follow. Now, when you've only got 8 cards to work with, it changes the entire balance of how you handle cards. When you've got 52 cards in your hand, you've got a different balance, but a small packet requires a different kind of energy to make the magic happen or appear to happen effortlessly. I've been working on this trick ever since I learned Darwin's routine. I went back to the original just to compare notes, and I stuck with the variation in handling procedure that Darwin gave us. Over the years, I've experimented and tinkered with different ways of getting into position and to create my own interpretation. What I'm going to share with you now is the way that I currently perform the routine, because once again, I asked myself, how would this look if I really had the power? And I hope you like the answer I've come up with. Thanks for watching. Have a good day. I'm a big fan of simplicity in my life. I was greatly inspired by the fact that the great composer Beethoven created one of his masterpiece symphonies with only a few notes. Was it 3? Was it 4 notes? The Fifth Symphony. When I look at the work of René Lavan, he was able to create beautiful magic out of the limitation of just one hand. I thought, you know what? Let's see what I can create for myself. A little symphony using just a few cards. 8 cards to be exact. Just 8, no more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And 4 of the cards just happen to be black spot cards. That's just for visual comparison to the 4 aces. 4 spot cards and 4 aces. Now I want to keep this as simple as possible to follow. So watch this very closely. As always, the ace of spades is the leader. Now the other 3 I'm going to leave out on the table in this fashion. Now we're going to start off with the ace of diamonds in just a moment. Now the black spot cards, I will leave one of them isolated right here with the ace of spades. Watch the first ace. Now the object is very simple. We're going to illustrate an old cliche that birds of a feather flock together. It doesn't seem possible because I still have 4 black spot cards over here. And as promised, the ace of diamonds. Now it has been said that a magician should never repeat a trick, but since we're doing this on camera, I'm gonna have to change procedure slightly. Watch this, we've got the 8 of clubs here. Remember this card, very important, because that goes down with the aces. And once again, 3 black spot cards over here. We just wait a few seconds for the magic to happen. Now, if this has worked, the 8 of clubs should be right back where it started, right here, with the other black spot cards. And once again, the next ace, the ace of clubs. We are now at that point in this conversation, ladies and gentlemen, where we are down to just 1 card, test conditions. The last ace, the ace of hearts. you all know what's going to happen. Watch me like a hawk, come in real close, ace of spades, ace of diamonds, and finally, the ace of clubs. One, two, three aces. And as I did before, I'll place one black spot card with the aces. I'll isolate the ace of hearts among the three spot cards. Now in magic, it's very important to have a big finish. One, two, three, four black spot cards. And right back where we started with all four aces. And that is my interpretation of Jazz Aces. Thanks for watching. Well, my friends, you've seen my approach to Peter Kane, Darwin Ortiz's Jazz Aces. I published a version of this handling on my DVD, The Quest for Mastery. I've gone back to it because I wanted to keep a picture in my mind of just something very clean, very simple, very direct. When you look at this, I'm sure those of you knowledgeable in card magic, you can see what's going on. I'm sure you're all familiar with it. Just keep in mind, do a 360 degree turn, or should I say 180. Put yourself out there in the audience watching yourself doing this. What would it look like? Would it look magical? Would it feel clean? Would it be stress-free, zero tension? This is the point of great card magic. If you can eliminate any kind of tension, incongruous handling, you're going to arrive at something very pure, very simple, and something that has the feeling of real magic, and something that would be enjoyable for your audience to experience. That's the whole point. So over the weekend, just take one of your favorite routines, do a 180 degree turn, and visualize yourself performing it to yourself. What do you want to see happen? And then switch roles, and then redesign, re-engineer everything so that you can have a perfect, congruent match to your vision. And it's your vision, your expression, that is a gift you will give your audience. And I just think the craft of magic is one of the few artistic and technical disciplines that can give people a gift they cannot get any other way. And that is the thrill of astonishment, the atmosphere of magic. Thanks for watching. Have a great weekend. Cheers. Bye-bye.